All victims deserve justice. I know that's a fundamental conviction that guides our Minneapolis Police Department. And what you'll hear from our chief in just a few moments is an example of that exceptional work done by our Minneapolis Police Department officers. But certainly, it is not an exception to the rule. Our officers are dogged and tenacious when it comes to solving these crimes, so I'm here to deliver a simple message to all of them. Thank you.
Almost 4 years ago, on July 16th of 2015, Ms. Susan Spiller was tragically and violently killed in her home on Dupont Avenue North in the very quiet, peaceful neighborhood of Lynn Bohannon. And that neighborhood was forever changed. My deepest condolences to the Spiller family and to Susan Spiller's son, Jason, who, as I mentioned, is with us here today. Ms. Spiller was an artist and a community activist. While her death shocked many, it was Susan Spiller's life and spirit that has inspired her community and our entire city of Minneapolis. As chief, I understand and I know that every death is heartbreaking, and every homicide brings additional questions and the need for answers. The wait for justice can be long and difficult. The Spiller family and members of the community have waited almost 4 years. And throughout those years, they remain supportive of the MPD and the investigation, calling in with tips and offering their support. Also throughout this time, a team of dedicated homicide investigators never lost their commitment to this case. Sergeants Anjos, Louis Porras, and Chris Caracostas have over 35 years of combined homicide investigative experience. Sergeant Caracostas has dedicated 4 of those years specifically to cold case homicide investigations. This team of devoted and experienced detectives never gave up on this case. Because of their relentless work and also the work of the professionalism of the responding officers at the scene, the expertise of our forensic crime lab, the support of the Spiller family and the community, combined with the committed, diligent work of our detectives and the partnership with our Hennepin County Attorney's Office, I am pleased to say that a suspect in this heinous crime has been identified, arrested, and charged. Our hope is to help provide answers and bring justice to the Spiller family and the residents of Minneapolis. And we thank you for your continued support in this very difficult case. Now it is my pleasure to introduce Mr. Tom Arneson, the managing attorney for the Hennepin County Attorney's Office of Juvenile Division. Mr. Arneson.
Thank you, Chief. Good afternoon. Last week, the Minneapolis Police Department presented a case to the Hennepin County Attorney's Office on an 18-year-old young man for committing the murder of Susan Spiller in July 2015. The County Attorney's Office would like to commend the Minneapolis Police Department on their commitment, professionalism, and dedication in this investigation. The arrest was of an 18-year-old young man. That suspect was 14 years old at the time of the murder. Because of the suspect's age at the time of the murder, there is very little that we are able to say right now about the case. Juvenile court statutes and rules require this privacy, and this is particularly restrictive for those who have committed crimes when they were under the age of 16. Here is the limited information that I am able to provide. The break in this case came when fingerprints from the murder scene were found to match the suspects. That did not happen until just recently, and it came up after the suspect turned 18, and those fingerprints were taken in an unrelated case. Based on the Minneapolis Police Department investigation before this break, as well as the follow-up afterwards, we felt confident that we had sufficient evidence to prove the case beyond a reasonable doubt. We therefore filed second-degree murder charges in juvenile court, and we applied for and received judicial authorization for an arrest warrant of the suspect. The suspect was arrested on that warrant yesterday and is currently in custody at the juvenile detention center, which, even though he is an adult now, 18 years old, that is the process when someone committed a crime as a juvenile. Because the suspect was 14 at the time of the murder, the proceedings are beginning in juvenile court. The proceedings will remain private unless a judge orders that the suspect be certified to stand trial as an adult. A 14 or 15-year-old can be certified to stand trial in a case such as this if the prosecution proves and if a judge finds by clear and convincing evidence that public safety is not served by keeping that person within juvenile court jurisdiction. That process will be followed in this case, and we will take it step by step, and we will do our best to ensure that justice is served.